welcome. I'm Peggy. Thank you so much for letting us be a part of your day. And we have a rather serious time here. And I'm so honored to have Reverend George Moore, Pastor George Moore with me. And we're going to talk about forgiveness and healing. And Pastor George has ministered all over the United States and, of course, Alaska and India. And he has inspired and helped so many people. And it's such a privilege to have you here, George.
Thank you, Peggy.
You've meant a great deal in my life. And I thought because we are approaching this really sacred time of the year, you know, we get all caught up in Easter bunnies and Easter egg hunts and all, and that's not bad. And if you have little children, but what does it really mean? What does this time of year mean and should mean to us?
Yes.
And of course, you always think about forgiveness. That's the ultimate forgiveness.
Yes.
On the cross.
Mm-hmm. And that is the beginning of new life, is to be forgiven. Or new relationship, or many other things that forgiveness has to be the beginning of whatever you're doing. Of course, Easter is all about new life. But so often, there is such an emphasis placed upon Easter morning resurrection that we overlook, we have a tendency to leave behind the Friday event of the cross.
Before we get into the serious discussion, I just want people to know a little bit about you. And you are a pastor at large at First Presbyterian Church in downtown Greenville. Now, you weren't always a minister. Where you were in the business world.
Yes, I was. I was with Prudential in financial planning for 12 years. I came out of the Air Force and went to work with Prudential Corporation.
And you're a native, I believe, of North Carolina?
A native of Southern Virginia.
Okay, all right.
A native of Clarksville, Virginia. And we served with Prudential in several states and in several roles. But I was 35 when I realized that I needed to answer a call that had been in my heart for years, and I couldn't settle it. I couldn't settle the issue that when I was a teenage boy, about 18, that I think God called me to full-time service with Him in a particular way. I thought it was in the ministry, in the pastorate. And I was of a nature that I wanted to do it my way. And I wanted to be in the business world. I have 9 brothers, and they were pretty successful, and I wanted to follow that path, which God let me do for a while. And then made it clear to me that He was wanting me to do something else.
And you were in the service?
Yes, I was in the Air Force 4 years.
Mm-hmm. 4 years in the Air Force, and then you decided you came out of that and
went in business with Prudential.
Yeah. And then?
And then
that crooked road led you.
It's been quite a journey. A lot of crooks in the road, but it's been a very, very exciting journey. I'm going to get to speak Sunday with a whole host of my nieces and nephews at my siblings' 90th birthday. I have a sister celebrating 90. And so I'm delighted to share with them the joy of serving the Lord Jesus.
So we're thinking about this troubled world, and there's such a need for healing, individual healing.
Yes.
And it's just very, very difficult. It's not easy. There's no magic thing you can do to all of a sudden.
Yes.
Everything is as it should be.
One of the things that makes our world so troubled is in the arena of relationships. There are so many broken relationships that drag us down because the things that broke us have not been fixed. They're not healed. And relationships are really the essential part of your and my happiness. I think most people would agree with that. It isn't things, it's not wealth, but it's having good, healthy, stable, loving relationships with other people. And it all begins with a relationship with God. And that's what it took me all of those years, from the time that I understood His call to finally answering, was that I realized that there was no peace in my heart. No matter what I would do, there was no peace in my heart. I was always restless. I was always searching for that next thing. And that was having a very serious and negative effect on my family, my marriage, of course. And it was out of that pain, you might say, that I just said, something has to change.
Now, you can't have healing without forgiveness, I guess. They go hand in hand, don't they?
Well, that's the way, I mean, we are healed in our relationship with our Creator, God. We are healed in our relationship once we recognize that we have missed the mark of what God created us for and to be. We've missed that mark. And that's, to me, the most definable definition of sin. It's not all about various things that we do. It's about the direction that we take. And our direction that we take misses the mark that God created us to be directed towards Him, to have a relationship with Him, to let the essential things of our life begin with God, and then trust Him to show us how He will give us the abundant life as we move out from Him into other relationships. But you see, on what we commonly know as Good Friday is that forgiveness part of the new life, where Christ gave his life as a ransom, actually bought us out of the power of sin through His sacrifice, and we then enter into that by faith, by believing, by giving our life to Him. Since He bought us out of the bondage of sin, we really are His. And quit fighting that and relax in that we are His, and let Him lead us into that journey of life that we refer to as a crooked path, and sometimes there will be a lot of briars and bumps along the way. But it's still a path that you see the light of God's love in as you give your life to Him.
I always remember as a little girl, why would they call it Good Friday?
Because we were bought, yes. Yeah. Out of the bondage through His sacrifice. And there's so much emphasis on the new life because none of us like to think about suffering and the movie that is now available called Son of God.
Yes.
People have told me the awesome impact that His suffering that's shown in that movie made on their hearts, my wife being one.
It's very, very real, isn't it?
Very real, yeah, very real. And Mother Teresa, the great servant of Christ that served the poorest of the poor in India, when she visited America, said one of her impressions is that Americans are very afraid of pain. I think that's a reasonable conclusion. As most any of us look around, we are very afraid of pain. And that.
Are you talking about physical pain or emotional pain?
I'm talking about pain. It can be either.
All right.
It can be either. We are afraid of it. And I think that's why we don't want to focus much on the cross of Calvary. We don't want to feel what he felt. But Jesus said to us, Jesus said, whosoever will follow me, let them deny themselves.
Pick up
their cross and follow me. And so whether I like it or not, once I realize that I am a person bound in sin, bound in self, bound up in desiring what I want rather than what might be what's best for others in the world. Let me be first is the attitude of sinful nature, self first. And then if there's anything left for the others, take what you can, kind of attitude. And Christ, of course, taught something totally, totally different. His message was so different from anything that I've ever heard, inasmuch as he gives himself for us. Many, many teachers have taught on the value of denying yourself and the value of humility. But he taught that I come to give my life for the redeeming of you, for the forgiving of your sin, and to show you the love of God the Father that you can enter into and be redirected in your life. And that's what real healing is being redirected. And that's what repentance is about. It's turning, being redirected in your life to where you direct your thought patterns and your life towards God, serving him, and then let him direct you from there.
And it's never too late for that.
Never too late.
I mean, no matter what situation someone may find themselves, it's never too late to start again.
No. The Bible that I have been spending the last 40-some years kind of testing to see if it was true, I found it to be absolutely true. And it says, his mercy is new every morning. And it says, come unto me, all of you who are heavy and burdened down. My heart is towards you, and my demands on your life will be light, and I'll give you rest for your soul. And that's what I have found. And I don't think we can have an understanding of healing until we understand how God has healed us. Then we can carry that out to others. And I think there are many relationships I find, particularly in my pastoral work with divorced people. Oftentimes, those former relationships are not healed. There hasn't been a proper recognition of personal wrong, and there hasn't been a real intentional desire to be healed with the other person. Oftentimes, people walk away from those very painful marriages with baggage of hostility and anger, and then carry that into some other relationship.
George, we're going to go to a break, and when we come back, I'm going to ask you, how do you learn to forgive? Okay. We'll be right back. Okay.